Hi. Let us solve this quadratic equation using the quadratic formula. Before that, we will write the standard quadratic equation. Ax squared plus bx plus c equals 0. The solution for this standard quadratic form is given by the quadratic formula, x is equal to negative b plus or minus square root of b square minus 4ac all over 2a. I'm going to pen this and move it aside so we can refer to that. Now, our goal is to compare the original equation to the standard form and try to find values for a, b, and c. So when you do that, you find a is the coefficient of x squared, and in the given equation, coefficient of x squared is 2, so a is same as 2. Similarly, try to compare the coefficient of x, and you get b is negative 6, and the constant term c will be negative 3. Now we take these values and try to plug them into the quadratic formula to obtain the solutions for the given original equation. Let us try to do that. When I plug a, b, and c in the quadratic formula, this is what I get. X will be negative b. Negative b would be negative of negative 6. Plus or minus square root of b square is squaring negative 6 minus 4 times a is 2 times c is negative 3 all over 2a will be 2 times 2. We will now proceed to simplify this further. Negative of negative 6 would be positive 6 plus or minus square root. Inside the square root we have square of negative 6. Square of negative 6 means negative 6 times negative 6. And so we will get 36. Now, look at the next one. Minus 4 times 2 times negative 3. So there are two negative signs in the product, and so negative times negative will give us a positive. And try to multiply the numbers now. 4 times 2 is 8. 8 times 3 would be 24. All over 4. And that would be 6 plus or minus square root of 36 plus 24 will give you 60 all over 4. Let us try to simplify root 60. So when you take, let me try to pen this. Okay, we're going to simplify this further. Right now we have 6 plus or minus square root of 60 all over 4. We want to simplify root 60. And in order to do that, we will have to factor 60. We know 4 times 15 is 60, and 15 can be further factored as 3 times 5. Now, this whole thing is divided by 4. And now we try to see how further we can simplify the radical. 3 and 5 are both prime numbers, so nothing can be done. They have to stay inside the radical. But 4 is a perfect square, which is 2 square. So when we split this radical upon 4, 3, and 5, and we can afford to do that because these are all factors. So square root of 4 will give just the 2 outside. And so we will have 6 plus or minus 2 times square root of 3 times 5, which is 15, all over 4. I'm going to pen this too. And let's see how to simplify the expression we got now, the solution, which is 6 plus or minus 2 root 15 all over 4. Let's see how to simplify this further. Now, if you look at the numerator, we have 6 and 2 root 15, which reads as 2 times root 15. Now, there's a 2 common to both the terms, and we can factor that out, which will give 2 times 3 plus or minus root 15 all over 4. And now you can divide this 2 with the denominator and get 2 in the denominator instead of 4. So the solution set for the given equation would be 3 plus or minus root 15 divided by 2. Write them within the set symbols. So we have two solutions here, 3 plus root 15 divided by 2, and 3 minus root 15 divided by 2. I hope this helps. Thank you.